U.S. tests $1 billion super advanced drones on aircraft carriers. The X-47B is a strike fighter-sized prototype drone developed as part of the United States Navy's UCASD Unmanned Combat Air System Demonstration Program, which aims to develop technologies necessary to field a combat drone on carriers. As a result, it has folding wings and is built for the rigors of sea life, including salt water, deck handling, and of course, takeoff and landing from an aircraft carrier. Although the X-47B is a prototype, the Navy hopes to actually field operational unmanned combat aircraft on carriers by the end of the decade. The unmanned flying wing aircraft, which takes some of its design cues from Northrop Grumman's B-2 stealth bomber, is supposed to demonstrate reconnaissance and strike capabilities. It has a full-sized weapons bay, although the prototype will not fly with weapons. And unlike existing drones, which are usually remotely flown by pilots once in the air, the X-47B is designed to fly autonomously, with just the occasional click of a mouse from an operator to send it instructions. It's a big deal, but it's an extension of something that was already happening, says Peter Singer, a senior fellow at the Brookings Institution in Washington, D.C., and the author of Wired for War, a book on the military's robotics revolution. The craft was revealed in 2008, but is only now undergoing sea tests aboard the U.S. Harry S. Truman, including moving around on the carrier. Whilst this kind of trial may not sound remarkable, in some ways it's one of the more challenging steps toward proving that the X-47B, which weighs in at 20,000 kilograms and has a 20 meters 62 feet wingspan, is ready for flight. The X-47B has already been tested on land in conditions meant to mimic operations on a carrier deck, including a catapult launch, but operating on a real carrier crowded with people and equipment presents fresh challenges. For example, the X-47B must be tested for electromagnetic interference, in other words, making sure that the aircraft's electronic systems don't clash with the myriad radar and emitters that are on a ship. While we go through a rigorous test program, you really learn a lot when you're at sea and you're validating your system against the true environment of the carrier, says Johnson. If all goes well with these tests, the Navy will then be ready for its first at-sea flight. This will likely be a sure affair, according to Johnson, and will start with a catapult launch and end with the aircraft landing, not on the carrier, but on firm ground. Later that year, the X-47B will also perform an arrested landing, meaning it will land back on the aircraft carrier. Another key flight test will take place in 2014 when the X-47 demonstrates that it can perform autonomous aerial refueling. Currently, the craft has a range of around 3,200 kilometers or 2,000 miles and can stay aloft for 6 hours. But for effective operations, the Navy would like it to stay aloft for longer.